Go ahead. My name is Amarjot Singh and you are calling me from where? The city?
I'm calling from Pattaya, Thailand.
From Thailand. Okay, go ahead. What's the problem?
Sir, problem actually is that I've been duped by someone living in Canada for since like 20 years as he claims, and means I have trusted him because he has been a close friend of my father, but we have lost touch since a long time. But again, we came to know that he's living in Canada, so my father got in touch with him, and he told me, and then my father said that, okay, you should speak to him about yourself and maybe he can help you. So to cut story short, I tried to talk to him and he said, okay, that it's very easy to get LMIA and work permit based on your experience of work and your English capabilities, and I can help you in that in just 15,000 Canadian dollars, and I'll be giving you LMIA in my own company. And he mentioned that I'm working with a very famous chef of India. And do you want me to take his name or not?
No. Okay, here, my purpose of talking to you is to solve the immigration problem, not to allege or not to take any names. Let me just, before you proceed, I know where is this call proceeding to. Let me just clarify. I have made more than 50 plus videos about work permit and LMIA and the connected fraud with it. Many people in Canada and maybe also in India who are connected to immigration consultant and lawyers, they are in the business of taking your money and providing so-called a job, which the job does not exist. Sometimes it does, sometimes it does not. When you pay a money, certain amount of money to a consultant, whether he's a lawyer or not, you are taking huge risk because there could be very possible multiple avenues of fraud here. The company is non-existent. There's no employer possibly, and they are just selling you a fake appointment. Again, even if the company is genuine, then there may not be job at all because the job does not exist. The employer and the consultant are sharing money with them, and they are duping people like you who are ignorant about the Canadian process. And third, even if the employer has any intention of hiring you, even for a month or maybe or a shorter time, they may give you the LMIA, they may give you the job offer letter, but the visa is not guaranteed. So when you apply for the Canadian work visa from the Canadian embassy in Bangkok, there's no guarantee that they will, you know, give you the work visa. And number four, even if you get the work visa, some people do get, even if you get the work visa, many a times I've seen people here in Canada who have come to meet me and they have got the work visa, but now there's no job. So you have, this is a political, complex situation by which you have the work visa and the work visa says that you must work for this employer, but the employer says, no. There's no job. My purpose was to allow you to facilitate your entry into Canada, to allow you just to come in. But we don't have any money. We don't have any business in the company. So how can we give you salary? And the fifth fraud is sometimes they will ask you to pay even more money so that you can pay them money and they will return to you in the form of salary and wages, which is again a fraud. So we have listed five different kinds of frauds connected with job offer. That is why I am not able to help you or anybody else. My purpose is only to allow enough information to people so that they understand what risk are you facing. Now, if you have already paid money to a consultant or agent or somebody else, there's nothing I can do about it. All you can do at present is tell those people, thank you very much. I'm not interested to come to Canada. Please return my money. Whatever you can get it. And that's the end of it. If that person, which we don't know, and I don't even want to know, don't even tell me the names, because maybe I know the names, or even if I do not, there's nothing, you know, Canada is a big country, and I'm sitting in Edmonton. Now, if you tell me some consultant or lawyer in Toronto, what can I do? If I tell them, you know, they will say, so what? I mean, this is my client, and who are you to tell me something? And so there's, I don't have any influence on anybody else. If they are lawyers in Canada, then you might want to find out their ID number. And if they are lawyers, or if they are ICCRC consultants, they also registration number. And based on that license and that registration license numbers, you can launch a formal complaint to the regulator. In that case, in Toronto, it's called Law Society of Upper Canada or ICCRC. You can search on the Google and then find out the complaint.
Yeah, Meets, I have actually tried doing all that stuff, but we were not able to locate any office, IRCCD code number, and anything.
Can I stop you just for a few seconds? So that is the procedure. If you are unable to find them and you are out of luck, literally, you know, your money is gone down the black hole drain. There's not much I can do about it. You know, I hope people like you can understand, and other people who are watching your story may just get a little cautious about it. But no matter how much I tell them, they continue to keep paying money to people who promise some kind of jobs, which is not going to materialize. So tell me exactly, and we have limited time, tell me exactly, what do you want from me?
Well, I would need your help in understanding that what are my opportunities in Canada, because, well, I am 32 to 33 years. In March 2020, I will be 33 years of age. And I have done my BCA in 2011. And now I would, I've already got an IELTS general score of 7.0 overall score. And I've got my ECA done from ICAS, from Canada itself. And my BCA degree is certified. But from my few consultants I have got in touch, they say that Sikkim Manipal University from India is not that much recognized, and many of the universities and colleges do not actually entertain that particular university. So, and I have a proper work experience in IT industry, and then there was an industry shift in like 5 years back, and since 5 to 6 years I'm in hospitality industry, and now I'm looking for some kind of a particular education course in hospitality industry from Canada, because I've been studying online for British Columbia, that there are many colleges which have very good hospitality courses, and I've seen many of the fraternity, the instructors who have posted their comments on their university, that there are very good courses, and that's the reason I'm planning to visit British Columbia and apply for a particular diploma course for hospitality industry. But from many of the sources, I have seen that they will not take me as a candidate. And due to my age and due to my gap in education, I really feel that I will not be able to apply. So
yes, can I respond now? All right. So you are single?
I'm just married. 2 years back, I've got married, and I and my wife are currently living in Pattaya, Thailand, and we have a hotel on lease, and we are working here as on work permit visa in Thailand.
Where are your parents living at present, in Thailand or India?
In India, Amritsar. And I have a hotel, I have a marketing experience. I have a hotel on lease in Amritsar as well of 26 rooms. And that I have 3 years of lease, which is about to expire in March. And that's the reason we moved to Pattaya, Thailand to start new career here. but our main goal was to pursue education in this same field so that I can have much more skill set in this field.
I've got it. Okay, just I've heard all about you, and just listen to my conversation, just listen to my conclusion, and then you can make your own decision about it. Even if your Sikkim Manipal University was recognized by IQAS, WES, you will still not be able to apply for directly PR based on your education and based on your professional experience, which I do not know is verifiable or not. But as far as study visa is concerned, you can, no matter what your gap is, if your English is good, which looks like it is, and if you have a good score in IELTS, then you should keep searching for colleges in BC or Ontario, wherever in Canada you get the admission. Don't be discouraged by one college declining your admission request. You should keep pursuing. There are more than, you know, I would say about, I've never counted, more than 200 plus colleges and institutions here who are offering different kind of courses. So you should continue to take admission once you get admission, and then launch your study visa application along with your wife directly from Canadian Embassy in Bangkok. You don't have to go to New Delhi. You can apply from there. That's all I can say. There's no more constructive, decision that I can see in your situation. So keep trying. Ensure that you can justify your gap, your about 9 years gap or whatever you were doing. Make sure that you have the professional experience certificates, your job income slips, you have a strong bank account, you know, for the past 6 months at least, showing transactions and funds, to go, and because you have to pay the fees and maybe pay the living expenses like GIC. You can go individually, you can leave your wife, you know, for time being,
now,
get settled. That is all it is. So forget about what happened in the past with some consultant, just focus and pursue your study visa ambitions in Canada. And that's all I have to say. And I have best wishes for you that you will be successful, because you seem like you have seen the world, you have been burned by bad experiences, your English is good, you have outside India experience, and then you are entrepreneurial. You may have some money to show as well. So I don't see any reason why your student visa will be declined. You take admission on your own, you apply for study visa on your own. I wish you well, but if you do get, I don't want to take your case right now because I want you to save money for yourself. You've already wasted money somewhere. Apply for visa on your own. But if you get refused, then you are welcome to call me back after a month or two. Then I will review the case and maybe possibly I can represent you in your study visa refusal. That's all I have to say. Thank you. Thank you very much. Take care, and I wish you well in your future.
Thank you. Thank you so much, sir. Thank you for taking out time to talk to me. Thank you so much.
Bye.
Thank you.